Uganda risks losing many foreign investors to other East African member states if the judicial system of the country is not aligned. The Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Major General Kahinda Otapere, has sounded a warning.
This ministry, first of all, to finish my programs, to make a contribution, there are quite a lot of things we still have to do to ensure that our justice dispensation system is respected. Because if you don't have a respected justice system, even investors will not have faith in your country. And if people who are coming to do business in Uganda don't have faith in our justice system, then they will simply cannot come.
The situation is worsened with the poor remunerations of state attorneys who are supposed to defend government in courts of law, but end up losing cases to petitioners in a move that is not yet clear on whether it is an inside job of connivers. This has resulted into loss of taxpayers' money to court awards made by judges. However, Otapere says the situation is still on unless government increases on the resource envelope of the ministry.
Money does not come from heaven. Money does not grow on a tree. The remuneration of just of state attorneys, judges, officials of the Judicial Services Bureau, the Human Rights Commission, the Electoral Commission, all depend on the size of the resource envelope available to the country. You know, the judiciary also competes with other government programs for resources. So the little we get is the little we dispense on the remuneration for our workers.
This has also accounted for the skyrocketing backlog cases in the judiciary, as many of the judicial staff who are supposed to handle the backlogs are resigning their jobs for private practice to make two ends of their life meet.
This backlog is a result of lack of manpower. And we don't have manpower because we don't have adequate resources to recruit sufficient judicial officers. And we don't have this money because the resources available to the country is limited.
Apparently, the judiciary is being portrayed as the second corrupt institution of government, according to the Inspector General of Government report of 2014 to 2015. To Otapere, the ombudsman needs to come up with evidence beyond reasonable doubt, other than making mere lamentations.
Corruption case, because you see, corruption is not a matter of perception. Corruption, you can only pronounce yourself on corruption when you have evidence. I'm not going to pronounce people corrupt when I don't have evidence, incontrovertible evidence that would stand the test of time in court. If God had created saints, there would be no jails. The fact that there are people who go to jail, without them, then there would be no police, there would be no judiciary. All these institutions were created to deal with wrongdoers. And you cannot have a system of government where there are no black sheep. They are there and they are dealt with. So if you have a case of corruption and you have evidence, report it to the police or the institutions that are mandated to fight corruption.
For the Sparsi, this television, Parliament.
Ha, ha, ha.